G'day and welcome to my garage. I have an interesting problem. I've machined this hub down 30 mil for the crank lever release, 30 mil for that, and then down to 25 mil for the snap ring, so I can put a washer. That goes on, then a washer, then the snap ring. The problem I have now is this small chuck, although it can grab that, I can't really grab it well, and I can't get it to be centre, and the hole I have in there now, which was what, 17 mil, it's too large for my live centre to engage. It actually goes just inside it. So how do I get this to hold? Oh. I'd advise you, if you do it the way I've done it, which is different to how Gingery's done it, I advise you not to do the step before you bore this out for the bush. That'll give you more meat up, or full meat up here to hold with the chuck jaws. Does that run on centre? Close, but not 100%. And that's only a drilled hole. That won't. I don't like that either. I can't indicate off that successfully. So, not too sure. Not too sure. The other thing I could do is mount the faceplate and bore this out to 30mm. Mount this on the faceplate and bore it out to 30mm, and with it still on the faceplate, glue the pillow block into the crank, and then that will keep it concentric. Yeah, that might be better. That will then keep it concentric. I'll look at that, because I'm not happy with the little engagement I'm getting with the chuck. It's enough engagement, but I'm not too sure whether this how to get this to centre. I'll have to play with that. Otherwise, put the faceplate on and do this first, mount that in there, glue it on, think about it. I've decided to go this way, mounting this thing to the faceplate. I'll centre it, bore this out to 30, and then mount this into the new bore. Yep, that'll fit. Okay, I just got to put a counterbalance on and we're on our way. Very close. 29 and a half. I've got to go a half. That's a quarter. We'll sneak up on it. another quarter cut, half. That's a quarter cut. Try that. Alright, so this is the way that I'm going with this. So I bored out the release crank to the 30mm. It's a tight 30. The pillow block is now sitting in, that machine collar is now sitting in the 30mm. Bore on the release crank, and I've jammed it in there nice and tight. You may see I've got a spacer here. That spacer gives me 26.5mm of that's 26.5mm depth of cut, because the bushing's 25, so it gives me just a little bit to play with. And we're currently at, what are we at? I've got to go to 22. 19. So 2.3. All right, let's take it out. 1.5, 2mm. So where are we at? We're at there. So that's a quarter, half. That'll be 1mm. A 1mm diameter increase. Says 20, and we've got to go to 22. Yep. So another, let's see, quarter, half. No, that's a half. And that's a half. My maths wrong. 21.2. So that's 0.8. 0.8. So yeah, 0.8. So 10 of these is 0.2. 10 is 0.2, that's a 0.4. So that's 3.36. Again, another 10. It's 0.36. Okay, let's go back again. 5 is 0.125. That's 0.125, that's 250, 0.25. What have I got there? 12. Bring it back to 11. Beautiful. Excellent. That will press in there. Beautiful fit. I just need to ease this out now so that it's a loose fit. Not too loose, but a loose fit for that, for this lever. Yeah. A little bit of play in there, that's good. That's good. We'll seize up on that. Beautiful. Good fit. Well, I've finished machining the pillow block bearings. I've got the bushing installed, and it's a modified journal just here. The oil cup fitted. So what's left now to do is fit the release crank to the journal, and fit a circlip or a retaining ring, however you want to call it. That's it. And this is the lever action that happens. Well, there's two of them. This is the from the so that connects the two fork pulley drive and shafts together from the motor frame to the spindle housing. One stage of the spindle, the primary stage of the spindle housing frame. So they're together. Now, I'll explain what's happened here, why it's different. Gingery calls for a 5/8 ball, 16 millimetres. The housing, the pillar block housing, to be drilled out to 3/4, so 5/8 from 3/4 is 1/8 total diameter difference, which would give a bearing or a bushing thickness of 1/16, 1.6 millimeters. Well, the bushings that I bought were 5/8, 16 millimeters, but they have instead of a 19 millimeter or 3/4 OD, these have a 22 millimeter OD, which meant the book's 3/4 OD or 19 millimeters is smaller than the bushing size. Well, that isn't going to work. So what I've elected to do is I've fitted the bushing. I've drilled this part of the housing out only out to a clearance size of 17 millimeters to clear the shaft. This part of the journal is 30 millimeters, and the snap ring part of the journal is 25. Obviously, the corresponding holes in the release crank release is now 30 plus to give me clearance. I'm still using a snap ring, of course, but that was the problem. It wasn't going to work. My bushing was bigger than the outside diameter of this journal, so I had to compensate for that. So I'm not saying that's a metrification problem. I don't understand how back in 1983 or whenever he did the book, how these bushings would only be 1/16 thickness. Yeah, that's not much. It's not much. Well, you know, you only need enough to get a bushing in there to make a shaft turn, but in this application that shaft could get a fair bit of slop in the bushing and still operate successfully. It's not like a gearbox, meshing gears or anything like that. It's just belts. So you can afford a bit of slop in the bush. That would have meant the bushing would have flogged out very quickly. Well, would have got to a point where the bushing disappeared very quickly. But anyhow, this seems to be working. I don't seem to have caused any other problems doing this. The length of this journal itself is a quarter of an inch longer. I can't remember now. But they will. If I'm looking at the milling machine, the lever is up here. Then that one goes on the left. No, that one goes on the right because the oil cap's got to be on top, and that one will go on the left. Journals face out. Both have got the legs pointing down. That's it. So they're done. Now back to cutting more steel for the framework. That was an interesting job. Quite pleased with that. Right, before we go on too far, these two crank release cranks, they're not quite finished, so before I get that one, steel transmission.